Explain three types of party system. First, we have is one party system. As the name suggests, one party system. In a country, there is only one party. Or even if there are maybe several parties, they do not have power to election or to make any major changes in the society. They are totally under the mercy of the main political party. So, one party system is a political system in which only one party controls and runs the government. Like example in China, the Communist People's Party, the main party that is there. Apart from this, there are other several 6 to 7 parties, but again, they do not have anything to say in the government. They cannot dominate the politics. Even if the candidate stands in the election, they need to have the permission of the main political party. Limitations of this system is there is no competition. So generally, as only one party is there, so no competition at all. Further, this system is specially popular in the countries where communist ideology is followed, like in China, in Russia, right? So example, I have given China, North Korea, Cuba, Burma, Laos. These are the countries where one party system is followed. And in one party system, the people do not have any choice at all, whether willingly or unwillingly. They have to vote to the candidate who is standing in the election. Second is two-party system. Again, as I said the name, there are two main parties in a country. So, competition is always there between those two parties. At least one step we can say better than unitary or we can say one-party system. A political system in which power changes between two major parties only. People have clear choice, either party one or party two. So the frame mind of the people is 100% clear. I want party A or party B. Strong opposition is good for democracy. As only two parties are there, one of them will come to power and other will be a very tough opposition party, always keeping eye on the government. And this is always a plus point for a democracy, because the role of opposition is equally important in democracy. If we don't have a good opposition party, then there are chances that the ruling party or the government may misuse the power. Prompt decisions are taken and implemented. It means the decisions that are taken or that are implemented are up to the mark and 100% proof. It is in the favor of the society and people, because there is no room for error. Why? Only two parties are there, and next time they will be thrown away if they don't come up to the expectation of the people. Small parties merge with the large parties. Probabilities or chances are there that there may be small parties, but those parties do not have opportunity to come to power. Like even in India, we have more than 1400 political parties. But generally what we see in one or the other state, whether it is at the state level or the central level, the probability of BJP, Congress is more to come to power. Or maybe in certain areas like in South, we have little difference. And in Northeast, there is little difference. Otherwise, in maximum states, now BJP is ruling. So though we have 1400 parties, still those parties do not have edge to form the government or to influence the government policies. Example of two-party system is USA, UK, Britain, what we say, Malta, Jamaica, Zimbabwe. These are the countries where we find two-party system prevailing at present. Multi-party system. Really a wonderful structure to learn about. A political system in which there are several parties, right? There are several parties who have an opportunity to come to power. Anyone can form the government, and that depends on their act, what they have done in the past, how they have worked for the society, for the development of the nation, and for the development of the people. But as it is multi-party system, generally we have seen that coalition government is more frequently formed, because for a single party to get majority is quite difficult. So they form alliance, that is main party along with other small party, they come together and form an alliance. Like in India, we have NDA, National Democratic Alliance. It's an alliance of BJP and its supporting party. Similarly, Congress and its supporting party is known as UPA. So these are the two biggest alliance that we have in India. Apart from this, we have many more, but these are the most well known in our country. Generally, as I discussed, okay, one party does not get majority, so alliance has to be done. They contest election together and finally they form the government. But if we see the last two Lok Sabha election, that is Lok Sabha election number 16 and Lok Sabha election 17. In both we have seen after a long time a single party getting majority, that is BJP. In 2014 election, BJP alone secured 282 seats of the Lok Sabha. And in 2019 Lok Sabha election, BJP secured 303 seats of Lok Sabha. So it's a great achievement for any party to get majority in such a vast democracy, in such a largest populated country, and that also where multi parties are prevailing. So parties can sustain only if they show their work. And if they fail to come to the expectation of the people are ruthless. Today, public has become quite aware. They only believe in development. They are now far away from those casteism, from discriminations. What they want is development of the nation, development of their life. And as I discuss, generally coalition government is there, the chances of instability is always there. Because to maintain the coordination between so many parties, it is a tough job. Because one or the other party is always not agreeing to your verdict or to your views. Examples of this is India, Brazil, Germany, Israel, Finland, Denmark, Spain, Italy, Iceland, Norway, etc. So these are the countries which are having multi-party system. Now the question arises, why India is having multi-party system? Or the question can be, which party system is ideal for any country? So first of all, I would say the question itself is not up to the mark. Okay, asking such a question, it's something wrong. We cannot decide, okay, I would like to have a multi-party system. A country cannot decide, or political parties cannot decide, or people cannot decide, okay, we would like to go for one party system, we would like to go for two party system, or we would like to have multi-party system. It's totally a different scenario. Different factors are there which decides whether the country will have one party system, two party system, or multi-party system. So let's see in the case of India. So no system is ideal for all. Means one party system, two party system, or multi-party system. It is not the best one or the better one in all the situation. As per the situation, the party systems keeps on changing, right? And that is, there are certain factors which makes this difference. There is the factor that influence the party system is the social geographical diversity that we have. The religion, if we talk about, so we have Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, and many more. So if only one religion party, say example, if party is only of Hindus, then what about the other religion? Talking about Islam, talking about Christianity, talking about Sikh. So they are not going to sit quietly. Even they want that they should have the political party which works for their religion, for their people. Further, when we move, there are caste under the religion, right? So in general, caste only, if we talk about, there are so many sub-caste and caste. So there the problem comes again. Okay, every caste or community wants to have their own people in the government. So again, it goes caste-wise, maybe region-wise, language-wise. So it becomes quite difficult. So in India, overall, if we talk about, it is social, geographical, economical factors that affects the formation of the party. And the culture, the heritage that we are carrying since ages. These are the factors that decide that India needs to have the multi-party system. If the scenario would have been only Hindus, as the name suggests, Hindustan. So when only Hindus were living in India, if that would have been scenario, then maybe possibility would have been different. We might have one party only. That is BJP, believing in Hindutva. So that would have been different scenario. But right now we have multi-religion. So that's why we have so many parties in India. Second, India is quite large. The 7th largest country and 2nd most populated country of the world. and the largest democracy. So the conflicts of the views, it is very, very difficult to make everyone happy. So everyone forms a separate party with a different thinking or minor differences in the thinking. So that is why India is having multi-party system. Now the question comes in our mind. We have learned one party system, failed. Two party system, failed or not up to the mark. Multi-party system, still not satisfied. So the question arises, how many parties do we need? So giving answer to this is quite difficult. We cannot say, okay, I want 5 party, I want 10 party. That is quite difficult to say. But yeah, we can classify the parties on the basis of their work, their popularity. So on the basis of their popularity and the work they do, right, we can classify the party into two. That is national party and regional party. We can say regional party as state party also. So let's learn what is difference between the two, that is national party and state party. So first, for any party to become a national party has to fulfill certain criteria, has to come to certain standard, has to fulfill certain parameters. So let's see what are those parameters. So the first parameter says, okay, the party that secures 6% of the vote of the Lok Sabha, that is the first condition to become a national party. Okay, the party should win 6% of the votes of Lok Sabha. Whereas for regional, again, 6% votes of the state legislative assembly. Second parameter says, to become a national party, the party should win 4 seats. Please listen carefully. 4 seats in 4 states, that is state A, 4 seats, state B, 4 seats, state C, 4 seat, and state D, 4 seat. So when a party gets 4 in 4 states, then the party is recognized as national party. Now the question may come in your mind, okay, sir, what about in one state, state A, the party gets 20 seats, in remaining they are getting 1, 2 and 3 or maybe 0 or less than 4, then what about in that condition? So my dear friends, then it won't be considered as national party. It is compulsory that it should win 4 seats minimum in 4 states. Then it will be recognized as national party. Whereas to be recognized as regional party, second parameter is to win 2 seats in the state where the party is prevailing. Yani jis state mein wo hai, wahan ki 2 legislative seat jeetna jaruri hai. Third parameter is, the national party generally deals with the national issues or the policies. It works for the development of the entire nation. The regional party, it works for regional issues or for that particular state only. National party work for the welfare of the entire nation. Okay, the policies that are made by the national party is implemented for the whole country. Whereas under regional, it is only limited to the state or the region. National party is more powerful, having more responsibilities, more duties, whereas regional party is less. Why? Its power or responsibilities are limited to the region only. And finally, we have the examples. National parties like BJP, INC, that is Indian National Congress, BSP, CPI, CPIM, and many more. Whereas regional parties like AAP, AIDMK, DMK, Janata Dal, and so on. So these were the few differences between the national parties and regional parties. Now we move on, learning in detail, in depth about the various political parties. And political parties, I mean to say, only the national parties that we have. So right now, we have 7 national parties. The first one is BJP, that is Bharatiya Janata Party. When we talk about Bharatiya Janata Party, so we go back to the history when our country became independent. After that, in the year 1951, Shyam Prasad Mukherjee, he formed a party named Bharatiya Jan Sangh. Later on in the year 1977, the party got split up. In the Lok Sabha election, it won, and from 1977 to 1980, it ruled at the center. And later on in the year 1980, right, under the leadership of Atal Bihari Vajpayee, L.K. Advani, BJP was formed, that is renaming Bharatiya Jan Sangh as BJP, that is Bharatiya Janata Party. So it came in the existence on 1st April 1918. The political symbol of BJP is lotus. Talking about its aim, so generally they emphasize their main agenda why this party was formed was to protect Hindutva. We have seen what happened with the Kashmiri Pandit during 1960s after the independence. They were thrown out of the Kashmir. Many were killed. So somewhere the existence of Hindu in Hindu country was in trouble. So on that basis, the party was formed. Second objective was to merge Jammu and Kashmir with Indian Union. No doubt now this dream is achieved, but that was the main objective why BJP was formed, to bring Jammu and Kashmir as a part of India. Uniform code for all. When we talk about laws, every religion has their own rules and regulation in one or the other area. Just giving you one example. For example, say divorce case. So when it comes to divorce, different religion has different procedure. Like in Islam, 3 times if they speak talak, 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 the lady gets divorced. In other differences. So to make it as uniform, right, in all the religion, the law is same. That is, as per the Indian Penal Code. That's what this says. Uniform code for all the Indian citizen, irrespective of their religion. Ban on regional conversion. Okay, many times people get converted from one religion to another. So there should be ban. Whatever community you are, your community or your religion is the best. It should be stopped. Conversion from Hindu to Muslim, Muslim to Christian, Christian to Sikh. No such activity should take place. Every religion is good at its own place. We cannot compare. So this conversion by few orthodox people from different communities should be stopped. Further, when we talk about 2014 Lok Sabha election, the results were as such, okay, out of 543 seats, BJP won 282 seats and formed the government at the center, right? NDA, that is National Democratic Alliance, together they got 336 seats. Similarly, in the year 2019 Lok Sabha election, BJP alone got 303 seats and NDA got 354 seats. So once again, single majority, and finally NDA is ruling at the center. Few prominent leaders at present of BJP are Narendra Modi, Amit Shah, Rajnath Singh, Nirmala Sitaram, and so on. So this was something about BJP. Before we move to the next political party, few suggestions for students how you can write short note on various political parties. So few tips, or we can say the parameters that you need to keep in mind. The first you need to keep in mind is the formation and the leader who formed the party. That is one point you need to cover up in the note. Second, the political symbol of the party. Third, aims and objective. The base on which the party was formed. Then comes 2014 and 2019 election result. Whether they formed the government, they are the part of the opposition. And finally, the last point you can write is few prominent leaders and the states where they are ruling or prevailing, where their presence is there. These are the points, if you keep in mind, you can write short note on any political party, that is seven national political parties. The second most important party is Indian National Congress. It is the oldest party of our country and the first party that was formed in our country. It was formed during the freedom struggle. It was formed in the year 1885 under the guidance of A. O. Hume, W. C. Banerjee, that is Vyomesh Chandra Banerjee, Surendranath Banerjee. These were the prominent leader who formed INC, Indian National Congress. The political symbol of INC is right hand palm, dahine hath ka panja, as you can see in the picture. The aim, what was the agenda, the policy, the belief why this came into existence? So they wanted to build a modern, secular and democratic India where people become more modernized, people have opportunity to follow any religion, and people have right to form the government. And it works for the welfare of the minorities that we have in India. Wants to have economic reforms with human face. It means the people should be given, the weaker section should be given more importance when any political reforms or economic reform is made. Talking about 2014 election results, INC could win only 44 seats and played the role of opposition. In 2019, again bad luck for INC and little progress, won 52 seats in Lok Sabha and altogether UPA, that is Congress plus its party, that is Alliance Together, won 92 seats. And again, once again, playing the role of opposition, which is very, very important for a good democracy. We move to the next one, All India Trinamool Congress. In short, we can say AITC, the party which became as national party in 2016, the latest one what we have. It was formed on 1st January 1998 under the leadership of Mamata Banerjee. Its political symbol is flowers and grass, as you can see the picture on the right hand top. The aim on what AITC was formed was to make India secular and federal country. It became national party in the year 2006 and is in power in West Bengal since 2011. That is continuously for the last 10 years it is in power. Talking about the 2014 Lok Sabha election, could win only 34 seats and in alliance with UPA played the role of opposition. In 2019, again could win only 22 seats, again alliance of UPA and is in opposition. States where generally we can see Trinamool Congress is the main state is West Bengal, Arunachal Pradesh, Manipur and Tripura. These are the states where generally these AITC is present. Now we move to Bahujan Samaj Party, in short BSP. You can see their political symbol, that is elephant, hathi. Founded under the guidance of Kansi Rap in the year 1984. The political symbol of elephant, the political symbol of BSP is elephant. In Hindi we call it as hathi. The aim was to secure power for the Bahujan. Bahujan means majority. So when we see the community in India, the maximum community in India is belonging to SC, ST and OBC. These three community together forms the Bahujan, that is majority community in the weakest section. So they believe that they should get the power, that is Dalits, Adivasis and OBCs. This party is inspired by the ideologies, a views of Sahu Maharaj, Jyotiba Phule, Baba Saheb Ambedkar, Swami Periyar Naikar. They are their mentors on whose ideas this party was formed. These are the great personalities who have worked for the weakest section of the society from the age when the Britishers were ruling on us. Talking about the Lok Sabha elections of 2014, couldn't open the account. In 2019, could win only 10 seats and presently supporting UPA and playing the role of opposition. States where we find BSP is UP, MP, UK, UK East, that is Uttarakhand, Delhi, Punjab. Presently, the party is led by Mayawati. The next party that we have is Communist Party of India, CPI. It was formed on 26 December 1925 by S.V. Ghate. This was the party that got split from Congress. As we see very often, when two great minds later on do not agree on the same issue, they start moving in two different directions. And that's why CPI was formed in 1925, the second oldest party of our country. The political symbol of this party is sickle and crop. Students, please do not get confused. In few places it is there that sickle is given and hammer is given. But when you Google up, it is given sickle and crop, not hammer. The aim is, it believes in the ideas of Karl Marx and Vladimir Lenin. So that's why their ideology is called Marxism and Leninism. Other ideas are quite similar to the other parties like secularism, but this is little bit different. They promote working class, that is working more for the development of the working class, farmers, poor. They are the main area where they concentrate, they focus more. They become weaker, that is in the year 1964, CPI become weaker because again there was, we can say, the thoughts changed within the party, and from CPI, one more party was formed or split, and that was known as CPI-M. As CPI got split from Congress and formed CPI, similarly from CPI, CPI-M was formed. 2014 election could win only one seat. Similarly in 2019, only two seats and supporting again UPA. States where we find these, Kerala, West Bengal, Punjab, Tamil Nadu, and currently with UPA. This is what we have for CPI party. The second one is CPI that I was talking. It was formed on 7th November 1964 after splitting from CPI. The political symbol, as I said, is sickle, hammer with a star. You can see this is sickle, this is hammer, and this is the star. The aim is quite similar because minor difference is there, as I said. That's why they got split into two. So the first ideology is similar, Marxism, Leninism, secularism. Second one, little bit difference, promoting poor factory workers. This is somewhat different, farmers and farm laborers. Talking about 2014 and 2019 Lok Sabha election, the party could not open its account, that is, did not win any Lok Sabha seat. States where it is prevailing or its domination is there is Kerala, West Bengal, Tripura. It was in power. It remained in power in West Bengal for 30 years before Mamata Banerjee, that is Trinamool Congress, came to power. It was this party that was ruling in West Bengal under the leadership of Jyoti Basu. The next we have is NCP, that is Nationalist Congress Party. Again, split from the Congress. Lots of split we have seen in the history from the Congress. So it was formed on 20 May 1999 by Sarad Pawar. The political symbol is analog clock, as you can see in the picture. The aim is making India a secular country on the ideology of Mahatma Gandhi. Works for the equality of the society. Wants to make India a democratic country, providing social justice to everyone, and wants to see India as a federal country where each and every level works independently at their level. Talking about 2014 Lok Sabha election, could win only 6 seats. In 2019, only 5 seats and supporting UPA. States where generally we find NCP is Maharashtra, Meghalaya, Manipur and Assam. And as I said, currently in alliance with UPA. Presently, the combination of NCP along with Shiv Sena, they are in power in Maharashtra, as we have seen.